Or Krog Stout. I've forged the breastplate of bravery. For Sir Bastion, the noble, the plate armor of fortitude, and the shield of resolve. And finally, Lila Windtalker, wearing the incredibly sturdy dragonmail of protection.
I think I'm missing a few pieces here.
Over the years, video games have gone from a simple pixelated pastime to an immersive experience that can tell fascinating stories. As time went on, the video game community evolved in ways that were good, but also in ways that were bad. One such aspect of video games that has come to receive tremendous amounts of scrutiny is the improper representation of women within games. To first confront this issue, the viewer must come to understand what the true population of the video game community is. Contrary to popular belief, it doesn't consist of solely a male audience. It was best described by Paul Verhoeven, a video game critic, during a TEDx talk describing sexism within video games.
Now, the game you're probably picturing realistically is this one. never get tired of looking at that face. When you deal with sexism on the internet and it's coming in a gaming context, it's usually coming from this guy. Not always, but it's usually coming from this guy. Now, this guy. Problematically, the game developing communities tends to have... Basically, they see these as the atypical gamers, so they cater almost exclusively towards these archetypal figures. And the one thing you may have noticed is that there's barely any females in the mix. You see, the game development community has drifted towards that dangerous notion that maleness is the norm. There was a big survey conducted by the ESA last year, and as of last year, 47% of gamers are women.
As it was shown there, women make up nearly half the population of the video game market, yet they're still being considered the minority and not treated in the same light as their male counterparts. Because of this, women are being discriminated against within the video game industry in two main ways, either being described as sexual objects or damsels in distress. Over-sexualization of women compared to their male counterparts has occurred frequently over the years that video games have been around. For example, take a look at the design for a set of armor from the popular game World of Warcraft. This is the same piece of armor for both the male and female character, but can you spot the difference? Sexualizations such as this are what many female characters are boiled down to in video games that have occurred over the last 20 years. In a study conducted by Melinda Burgess, Steven Sturmer, and Steven Burgess in 2007, 225 game covers were observed and reported on how the male and female characters were represented within the artwork. For the women, their body representation was rated on a scale of busty, super busty, or normal, with normal being the average breast size. And males were rated on a scale of muscular, super muscular, and normal, with normal being average. Of the game covers observed containing viewable characters, 49% of the females were portrayed as either busty or super busty, while 25.7% of the male characters were portrayed as muscular or super muscular. The researchers also came to find that 38.5% of the female characters viewed had nothing more of a role than to be eye candy. This meaning they performed no identifiable action other than to titillate the audience. This research showed that when comparing the significance of males and females within the visual representation, over-sexualization was much more prevalent with the females than with the males. Now, to go along with this is the second faulty representation of women in video games, the damsel in distress cliché. The most prominent character to be shown in this light is the perpetual love interest of Nintendo's Mario, Princess Peach. Within nearly every Mario franchise game, the plot consists of the villain Bowser capturing Peach and holding her against her will until the lovable Italian plumber saves her from the evil Koopa's clutches. Now, the story itself might seem innocent enough in its plot, but the message it's trying to portray about women is where the problem arises. It was best expressed by the YouTube channel Feminist Frequencies on an episode where they covered damsels in distress.
One way to think about damsel characters is via what's called the subject-object dichotomy. In the simplest terms, subjects act, and objects are acted upon. The subject is the protagonist, the one who the story is centered on, and the one doing most of the action. In video games, this is almost always the main playable character, and the one from whose perspective most of the story is seen. So the damsel trope typically makes men the subject of narratives, while relegating women to the role of object. This is a form of objectification because as objects, damseled women are being acted upon, most often becoming or reduced to a prize to be won, a treasure to be found, or a goal to be achieved. At its heart, the damsel trope is not really about women at all. She simply becomes the central object in a competition between men, at least in its traditional incarnations. I've heard it said that in the game of patriarchy, women are not the opposing team, they are the ball. So for example, we can think of the Super Mario franchise as a grand game being played between Mario and Bowser, and Princess Peach's role is essentially that of the ball. The two men are tossing her back and forth over the course of the main series, each trying to keep and take possession of the damsel ball.
So as it's been shown, the video game industry is a majority instills a mindset within players that males are the dominant alpha of importance, while females are watered down to little more than an item to be viewed upon or obtained. This creates a superiority complex within the male players and an inferiority complex within the female players. In a test conducted by Elizabeth Bem-Morowitz and Dana Mastro, they had participants play the game Tomb Raider Legend with either a sexualized heroine, non-sexualized heroine, or to not play the game at all. At the end of the experiment, the results showed that playing the sexualized character versus no video game resulted in lower self-efficiency for female participants, suggesting that exposure to sexualized images of women in video games among female players may reduce confidence in their ability to succeed in the real world. This negative outlook on women has been ingrained in video game culture for nearly as long as it's been around, and because of this has become a norm for gamers to see on a daily basis. It then falls on the future consumers of video games to vocally express their distaste for this crooked way of thinking and strive for an industry of proper representation. Only when people speak up will change finally begin, and it may be a slow process, but it will create something better for those yet to come.